चतुर्थोऽध्यायः
द फोर्थ चैप्टर
कैवल्यपादः
द सेक्शन ऑन यूनिटी
जन्मौषधिमन्त्रतपःसमाधिजासिद्धयः
सिद्धीज और अटेनमेंट्स आर बॉर्न आउट ऑफ जन्म बर्थ औषधि मेडिसिनल हर्ब्स मंत्र इनकैंटेशंस तप पेनेंस एंड समाधि और इक्वानिमिटी
जात्यंतर परिणाम प्रकृत्या पूरात
जाति और काइंड ऑफ बर्थ कीप्स ट्रांसफॉर्मिंग बेस्ड ऑन वन्स अनफुलफिल्ड टेंडेंसीज
निमित्तम अप्रयोजकम प्रकृतीनां वर्णभेदस्तु ततः क्षेत्रिकवत्
द पाथ दीज टेंडेंसीज टेक आर निमित्त इंड्यूसर्स ऑफ बर्थ एंड अप्रयोजक नॉट द कॉज ऑफ इट सिमिलर टू हव ए फार्मर इंड्यूसर्स क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन बट इज नॉट द कॉज ऑफ इट
निर्माण चित्तान्यस्मिता मात्रात्
चित्तानि Individual minds are created merely by identification with asmita or sense of individual self.
Pravritti bhede prayojakam chittamekamane kesham.
These individual minds of the many are in fact one, but seem divided due to being employed in different kinds of activity.
Tatra dhyana jamanashayam.
And by meditation upon this truth is born anashaya, or lack of intentions.
Karma shukla krishnam yoginas trividhamitaresham.
Karma or actions are ashukla, not bright, and akrishna, not dark for the yogis, but for the others it is of three kinds, bright, dark, and grey.
Tatastadvipakanugunanamevabhivyaktirvasananam.
In that threefold division of activity, based on the results of those actions, vasana or tendencies are manifest.
Jati desha kala vyavahitanam apyanantaryam smriti samskara yoreka rupatvat.
This manifestation is a continuous process, even if it seems divided by jati, birth, desha, location, and kala, time. This is due to the unity of form between smriti, memory, and samskara, tendencies.
Tasam anadityam chashisho nityatvat.
These tendencies are originless due to the eternal nature of ashisha, primordial desire to live.
Hetu phalashrayalambanaihi sangrihi tattvadesham abhave tadabhavah.
This framework is held together through hetu, cause, phala, result, ashraya, recipient, and alambana, support. Once these cease to exist, the tendencies too cease to exist.
Atitanagatam svarupatostyadvabhedadharmanam.
The past and the future, in fact, exist distinctly within the present form, due to the difference in the adhva, path, of their dharmas or properties.
Te vyakta sukshma gunatmanah.
They are either manifest or lay subtle, according to the nature of one's gunas.
Parinamaikatvad vastu tattvam.
Due to the uniqueness of these transformations, unique personalities are manifest.
Vastu samye. Chitta bhedat tayor vibhaktah panthah.
These unique personalities and differentiation in individual minds result in different life paths, even if they are all same at the core.
Na chaika chitta tantram vastu tadapramanakam tada kim syat.
The mechanism of creation cannot happen with a single expression of mind. What could ever happen when there is nothing to be observed in comparison to the other?
Taduparaga pekshitva chittasya vastu jnata jnatam.
Something is only known by a mind it has colored or made an impression on. Otherwise, it is not known.
Sada jnatas chitta vrittayas tat prabhoho purushasya parinamitvat.
the cyclical actions of the mind are always known to that superior sense of self due to its nature of being untransforming.
Na tat svabhasam drushyatvat.
That is not perceived to one's own self due to the nature of external sight.
Eka samaye chobhayanavadharanam.
And since both these perceptions cannot be held at once.
Chittantara drushye buddhi buddhe rati prasangah smriti sankarascha.
If chitta or mind, which is like a mirror, were possible to be seen by itself, the chain of such perceptions would regress infinitely, mixing up and confusing smriti or memory.
Chitera prati sankramaya stadakara pattau svabuddhi samvedanam.
Due to apratisankrama, unchanging nature of chitta, mind, when the perception of forms is born, that is when one feels the activity of buddhi or the faculty of intellect.
Drashtru drushyayo paraktam chittam sarvartham.
The mind on which both drashtru, seer, and drishyam, that which is seen, are imprinted upon, fulfills all of its purposes.
Tadasankheya vasana bhischitramapi parartham samhatyakaritvat.
Even after being imprinted upon by countless latent tendencies, its purpose is something else due to the nature of being employed by it.
Vishesha darshina atma bhava bhavana vinivrittihi.
For the one who perceives everything completely, the very sense of self and the feelings born out of it cease to exist.
Tada viveka nimnam kaivalya pragbharam chittam.
It is then that chitta or mind becomes inclined towards true discernment and gravitates towards kaivalya or unity.
Tachidreshu pratyayantarani sanskarebhyah.
Any gaps in this discernment lead to the emergence of various thoughts and intentions from the storehouse of latent impressions.
Hanamesham kleshavaduktam.
The process to overcome these is similar to the process of overcoming kleshas or obstacles as mentioned before.
Prasankhyane pyakusidasya sarvatha vivekakhyater dharma megha samadhihi.
When one is not entangled with even the highest states of attainment, such distinguished discernment is called as dharma megha samadhi, or the state of equanimity that liberates from one's very own nature.
Tatah klesha karma nivrittihi.
This realization extinguishes both the causes of suffering and the cycle of cause and effect.
Tada sarvavarana malapetasya jnanasyanantyajneyamalpam.
Once all the veils and impurities concealing truth are washed away, one's insight becomes boundless, resulting in very little that is left to know.
Tatah kritarthanam parinamakrama samaptir gunanam.
Then, once their purpose is fulfilled, gunas or qualities stop the series of transformations among themselves.
Kshana pratiyogi parinama paranta nirgrahya kramah.
At the end of these transformations, this continuous flow can be grasped as actually being a collection of discrete moments.
Purushartha shunyanam gunanam pratiprasavah kaivalyam svarupa pratishthava chiti shaktiriti.
The outcome of qualities that have absolutely no intentions associated with them is called as kaivalya. An establishment in one's true self is called as chiti shakti, or the power of consciousness.
Iti Patanjali virachite yoga sutre chaturthah kaivalya padah.
Thus is the fourth chapter called Kaivalya Pada in the Yoga Sutras, composed by Sage Patanjali.
Iti Shri Patanjala Yoga Sutrani.
Thus conclude the Yoga Sutras of Patanjali.